by you who wants to build amazing new web stuff. You who has heard about AMP, both good, weird, and scary. You've come to the right place. Let's debunk the 5 most common misconceptions about AMP. Number 1. AMP replaces websites. Let me go back one step. AMP is both a web components format and library. Compared to other libraries and frameworks, AMP's biggest difference is that it takes a whitelist approach in what you're allowed to do. So why take away things? Because it's too easy to degrade a site's performance with a seemingly innocent little piece of code and too hard to debug what caused it many months later. But AMP doesn't just take away things. It offers lots of custom tags with advanced built-in functionality and comes with a spec that documents what kind of standard HTML tags are okay to use. When following these rules, AMP ensures the site stays on a fast path. But wait, isn't there more to it? Actually, no. AMP is really just that, a web components ecosystem. But because it's so easy to confirm programmatically that a page is a valid AMP, it enables all sorts of cool things. Among those cool things are, for instance, a fast free caching system for all valid AMP pages through an AMP cache, a pretty good bet that a validated AMP page is fast and user-friendly, and AMP pages are self-contained and can be safely embedded into third-party platforms. And this last point in particular allows these kind of platforms to do cool things with it, such as the top stories carousel on Google Search, or linking to AMP pages on Pinterest, or even consuming AMP pages as data source within a progressive web app. Number 2. AMP restricts my layout and design abilities. You'll be surprised how much you can do on AMP pages. All things considered, there are very few limitations on how you can style your site. Want to go crazy with a 5x nested flexbox layout? Go for it. Crazy pseudo-elements based UI? Sure. Your limit is your imagination. Number 3. AMP is for light experiences. Well, light in the sense of not hogging my CPU and battery? Sure. Light as in another crappy MDOT experience that strips away most functionality? Definitely not. AMP is, strictly speaking, targeted at static content. But said static content is getting more and more dynamic, kind of crazy cool art-directed animations, sidebars, lightboxes, accordions, carousels, and more. Check out some of the advanced examples over at AMP by Example. And don't let the simplicity of AMP and the fact that you're not writing JavaScript fool you. Number 4. AMP is just for mobile. The mobile in accelerated mobile pages definitely doesn't help to debunk this, but it is in fact far from the truth. AMP is an extraordinarily powerful solution across all surfaces and was designed with the objective of allowing publishers and developers to shift engineering resources from the grind of supporting multiple platforms to instead focus on creating great new content that can then be easily available for all users on any device type. So contrary to popular belief, AMP is built from the ground up with responsive design in mind. Most third-party platform integrations are currently focused on mobile, but you'll still get many of AMP's benefits on desktop. Check out our docs in the description to learn how to use AMP across all resolutions and device types. Number 5. I can't use AMP with my current website. Now that we've debunked the styling and mobile questions, there's no reason why you couldn't use AMP with your current website. As you now know from the previous points, AMP is really just a web components library. In fact, the AMP homepage itself uses AMP exclusively. Of course, like with any library out there, AMP isn't for everyone. Think about whether you can live with AMP's imposed restrictions, and only if the answer is yes, make the switch. For a rule of thumb, if you don't have static content and your pages aren't leave pages, meaning pages that are entry points, for instance, that people click on in search engines, AMP might not be for you. So there you have it, 5 misconceptions with 5 debunked answers, hopefully giving you a bigger, clearer picture of AMP and whether it's a good fit for you. Have any more questions? Get in touch via the comments or on Twitter and subscribe for more of this. Onwards.